And the money.
Every penny of it.
The Treasury has agreed to stake you in the game.
Vesper. Now I hope you gave your parents hell for that.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Your boss must have some influence. I've never seen so much go out the door so quickly.
Or so stylishly. May I ask where it is?
10 million was wired to your account in Montenegro with a contingency for 5 million more, if I deem it a prudent investment. I suppose you've given some thought to the notion that if you lose, our government will have directly financed terrorism. What looks good? Okay, so you're telling me it's a matter of probability and odds. I was worried there was some chance involved.
Well, only if you assume that the person with the best hand always wins.
So that would be what you would call bluffing?
Ah, so you're familiar with the term. Then you may also have heard that in poker you don't play your hand, you play the person across from you.
And you're good at reading people?
Which is why I'm able to detect the undercurrent of sarcasm in your voice.
Well, now I'm assured on my knees in safe hands.
From which one might surmise that you aren't overwhelmingly supportive of the plan of action.
There's a plan? Goody. Somehow I was under the impression we're risking $10 million in the lives of hundreds of people in a game of luck. What else do you see, Bond?
About you?
Yeah.
Well, your beauty is a problem. You worry that people won't take you seriously.
Which one might say of any attractive woman with more than 2 brain cells. My turn. By the cut of your suit, you went to Oxford or wherever, and you actually think people dress like that. But you wear it with such disdain, which makes me think you didn't come from money. And all of your school chums rub that in your face every day, which means you were at that school by the grace of somebody else's charity. Hence the chip on your shoulder. And since your first thought about me ran to orphan, that's what I say you are. Ooh. You are. I like this poker thing. And that makes perfect sense since MI6 looks for maladjusted young men who give little thought to sacrificing others to protect queen and country. You know, former SAS types with easy smiles and expensive watches. Amiga. Beautiful. Now, having dismayed you, I wouldn't go so far as calling you a cold-hearted bastard. But it wouldn't be a stretch to imagine that you view women as disposable pleasures rather than meaningful pursuits. So as charming as you are, I'll be keeping my eye on our government's money, and I'll feel perfectly formed ass. Good day, Mr. Bond.